lose minus win format. So you really need that 2-0 for your team. Let's go.
Let's go.
Game number two, ladies and gentlemen, the 4-1 lineup of Geek Fab versus the late game Sustain and Push for the side of SDI.
Yeah, late game super scale with the Zask, with the carry.
Yep.
I mean, Zask is just so strong with ultimate, but you know what? Carry is just a beast.
Yeah.
But if and only if they can control the map. You know what? If they want to control the map, they have two of the best heroes to do it.
Yeah.
Vision with the Diggy.
Yep.
Vision with the Selene.
And make that three because you have the worms from Zas. So
yes.
Again, if you are a Claude or probably a Nana, you're really going to have a hard time in positioning yourself and get all of those damage. But let's see here still. The range game is on the side of GeekFab because you have this Farsa. There you go. Again, both of the teams starting it out safe. Getting their blue buffs and getting their own Little Wanderers in the mid lane. But again, why not here? Initiating the team fight.
This is what I was talking about. Perfect execution from Why Not. Slows down UG for first blood right there. What a play.
Same plan for both of the teams. The only difference is Team Geek Fam getting the upper hand because of the stun and because of the Molina Smooch. Because the slows. And they will now delay the farm for Mr. Yuji, Mr. Mage Dad.
Yep.
What are you going to do to get back?
I mean, that's a big question right now. May doing his very best on the ball lane as well. But man, I feel so bad for Yuji. I mean, they were SDI had so much trust in the guy. They left him alone in the mid lane against three people.
Yeah.
Just because they know they can survive. But look at the top lane again.
Okay.
The default fall down. This time they're trying to get for the revenge. Oh my gosh, the flame shot.
Unfortunately for Yuji, quite a little bit of mistake there.
Yes.
For Yuji, but again, okay, that is the revenge arrow for Lembot. So,
okay.
SDI, they're doing fine. They're doing fine.
Yeah.
Nice pick off.
And if you want to give kills over, you got to give it to the... To assist to the carry, you gotta give it to the Zask.
Yep.
They're doing the right thing.
They're doing the right thing. Plus, they did delay Cortese here, who, again, like what we've said, needs to farm.
Yep.
He has the Bounty Hunter here, so I think he needs to utilize this. Team SAI, they're not backing down for from a fight. There you go. That is the setup. Bouncing ball coming in from Why Not. Feathered airstrike from Exord just to spam out the waves.
Yep.
They're defending this top tier tower.
Oh my god, what happened to Yuji right there? He just got taken out there on the side. May going down as well as a revenge.
An off-cam kill after an off-cam kill right here. Don't go. Yeah.
Right.
We're the Suicide Squad. Right?
Yeah.
We're the Suicide Squad. Alright.
We're back.
Back to the ball game.
Alright, so the bottom lane, Cortese again against Nitsu. No immediate threats against Cortese.
Yeah.
He can take his time. The only problem with Cortese is not utilizing that Bounty Hunter properly.
Yeah, but again, he has all the space in the world to just farm. I think if you are a Claude, as a Claude player myself, I don't look for kills.
That's true.
Yeah, the kills will just come and go. Your
it's
only
a bonus.
Yeah, it's a bonus. Your only priority is just farm up all of the waves. Make sure that your Art of Divinity has full stacks.
All the time.
Yeah, all the time for you to have this mobility. And just hope for the best that your teammates can do their jobs.
Yeah.
Can do gaps.
Yeah, the only job that you have as Cortese is to just jump in when everyone's very busy and then do the damage with the Blazing to win.
Definitely,
right? Again, that's a big problem here at the same time because there's so many traps to avoid, there's so many bombs to avoid.
Yeah.
If you dive in, you know what? Zask can hide inside the Nightmaric spawn.
The Nightmaric spawn,
So, there's actually a bit of a time. Geek Fam right now, they have SDI on a timer.
Definitely.
You know, you have to destroy us before maybe 12, 15 minutes.
Yes.
After that, it's going to be very scary for you guys because we have a powerful Farsa, we have a Claw.
Yeah, I agree with you, Rockheart. I definitely agree with you. But same goes for SDI right here because Gripsu is now at level 6 and I think he is farming pretty well. If you're going to look at the gold right now, it's dead even.
Yeah.
Only 100 gold lead here for Geek Fam. But again, this is Geek Fam. They always prioritize objectives. So right now, if you're going to look at the mini map, they are now setting up for another turtle take.
Yeah.
Here we go. 5 seconds in, going back. 2-2. what's gonna happen?
You know what? I like this because they have an advantage. Because STI, they're not ready with the traps. They're not ready with the time bombs.
Oh.
They have to just back off.
Yeah.
And, this is a perfect time to take a turtle, but they're ignoring that.
They're ignoring
that. And for the meantime, they just want to play safe because they're not sure. Maybe STI is in the bush here somewhere.
They don't want to risk it.
They don't know.
Yeah, they don't want to risk it.
Bottom lane, looks like Nixu having a bit of a tough time here. May could have gone for the kick. Oh. A bit too late. Purified by Nixu. The backup is here, and the kill goes to STI.
That was nice for Team STI. Another bonus here for Yuji and Nixu. Nixu doing pretty well as the Uranus. Nobody can stop him now.
Yeah.
Even the Cho. Probably the Cho can serve as an answer, but again, it's the Uranus meta right now without any burst right here.
Oh my
but
gosh.
As I say this, there is going to be a pickup here, okay?
Alright, very, very close. Again, yeah. GeekFam, they knew they were going to lose the bottom lane right away. So they went ahead and sacrificed that. They got a turtle on the top.
Yeah.
They got a tower on the top.
Yes.
I would say that's still a win.
It is another equal trade again for Team GeekFam. May is just defending this. They're just joking around, both of these guys. The old laners, Mei and Nixu, saying hi to each other. The action is in the mid lane.
Absolutely.
But again, the camera has chosen this one to view. And okay.
Because they know that Nixu's Purify is down.
It's down,
But they don't know that the timer is on Purify is very quick. So
yes, definitely.
Mei might be in for a bad time. And Nixu on the
Oracle
there, very smart pickup.
Yeah. Extra HP here, extra sustain for Nixu, but again, Cortese just going for the extra goal. Nixu defending the bottom tier tower as Wynot and company will try to gank out Kripzu, but they will fail. But again, the firepower of Team GeekFam is just so huge right here.
Demon Hunter Sword for Cortese, that's 50% completed on the items that he needs.
Yep.
For the massive amount of damage they're absorbing right now, GeekFam, they're caught in a very bad position.
Oh my!
Why not? All alone, two kills for nothing, STI all of a sudden.
Why not's ultimate, I think, is on cooldown right here, and even Exort. So with SDI knowing that was the perfect opportunity for them to strike.
Smart play.
Yeah, that is a smart play. Again, defense is the best offense here for Team SDI. With this type of composition, where you have all of this, what do you call this, zoning skills?
Yes.
And if you fight inside a narrow space, you will definitely win.
Yeah, and they were in a good position as well. There was no escape point.
Yes.
For GeekFam at that point. But right now, again, GeekFam, they're not going to take this lying down. They will get something else in return.
Yep.
Getting that turtle for an equal trade.
Getting another equal trade here. Value trade, to be exact, for Team GeekFam. Exort now having the Lightning Truncheon. There you go.
Yeah.
But they're all these checkpoints.
So many stuff on the map.
Yeah.
So right now, Mei.
There you go, Mei. That's out.
Oh, the damage shot. What the heck? Flame shot is real.
Let's talk about range. That is the answer.
Yep.
For GeekFam, and man.
So scary, right?
So scary, yeah. GeekFam with a snap.
When you hurt them, they hurt back really hard.
Yeah, they hurt back really hard. Immediately turning the tides and getting back. And they are now pressuring all lanes here. And man, Exort and company here, CKTD and Wynot, doing pretty well.
Yep.
And picking off heroes.
Why not? Gonna be stunned up here a little bit. Not gonna be able to be dove in by Lembot.
Yep.
It's really scary to dive in on your own on a Cooper, because if you go bouncing ball mode, you're gonna get bounced back.
Yeah,
you're gonna get bounced back.
Yep.
So right now, the control of the jungle is very critical, and GeekFam trying to see if they can contest that as well. They're scaring SDI right.
Yep. This is just the teamwork for Team GeekFam. You first land the Molina Smooch, and then you will go for the Tyrant's Revenge.
It's a big boom.
It's a big boom.
Yeah.
Like what you said, 4 or 5 years. Vintage GeekFam.
It doesn't feel like 4 or 5, right?
It doesn't. SDI, they need a miracle here. There you go. This is just a bait play from Nixu. Why not trying his best?
Yeah, no one was really following. He was just scaring everyone.
We
have 4 people on the bush. Just kidding.
Just kidding.
While that was happening, geek fan with a push on the tower.
Oh my.
So smart.
Oh
big
my.
Please.
This is just all about the lineup here, all about the draft here. And as Midnight said, he is 100% sure that SDI doesn't have a good draft against this type of composition for Team Geek Fab.
What a statement.
Yeah,
right?
what a statement. He will definitely drink his coffee if Geek Fab wins here. But again, SDI, we're not losing hope on you guys.
No,
Let's see. Is defense the best offense here? But again, Yuji falling down two times in the early stages of the game. That's definitely bad news.
It is. And Yuji, one of their core mages here, 1, 2, and 3.
Oh my.
Limbo 0-0-4. Not able to make any pickoffs.
Yeah.
As a Selena, you need to be able to make a pickoff for you to be effective. Right now, you're just a walking board.
Yeah.
You know?
He is probably a scouting arrow there.
Yeah, scouts and boards.
For Team SDI. And Geekman, they just need to lessen all of these deep dives. And they will definitely get a beautiful setup here. There you go. Why not stretching his arms? Mei is lurking from behind. He will target Yuji. But Yuji with the clutch ultimate there just to survive. Meanwhile, Good Dizzy is here. Flame shots coming in from everywhere. But Yuji.
Blazing 2 on 3.
Yuji falling low.
What a great follow up there. They got him. They got what they needed. But
the bait.
Jebaited.
Exoit with a Feather air strike.
4-3.
4-3 from the parking lot. Gets 3. And that makes it 2-1 for that skirmish. But still, Geek Fam, they want to get the mid-tier tower. It's not over, ladies and gentlemen.
That's right. They got the mid-tier tower, but I think they should stop at that. Because right now, the rest of SDI will be able to recover. The dead timers are not that bad yet.
Yes.
So they're not completely down, but they're... It's gonna be a far climb going back up on even.
Oh my. Outplays after outplays here. But man, Geek Fam having the
Geek
upper
Fam,
hand.
Man.
This is a free lord for the taking here. Plus, they are negating all of these objectives that SDI can have.
Yeah. Just when you think Geek Fam was about to go down.
Yeah.
You know, the big revenge play. Just when you thought Curtizzi, oops, that looks like a mistake.
Yeah.
No, it's not.
That is.
Patience.
From Curtizzi. If you're playing the Claude, you really need to have a huge amount of patience.
Yeah, and look for that opening, the perfect opening to go for the big play.
Yeah,
right?
The blazing duet. Again, it's your only tool. It's your only tool for you to bring in the damage. But look at this. If you look at the minimap right now, Mei
massive
playing in the bottom lane, controlling that bottom lane.
So scary. And this battle completed as well. He feels so scary. Because don't remember, this is going to be a scary fight on the top lane, 4v4.
Who's going to die?
Big engagement on the back line, Curtizzi, so scary, goes for left.
But Grimsu, he's everyone, he's all alone. The damage is not enough. Four heroes.
Triple kill for left.
Are
dead. Curtizzi.
Yes.
And Exort, he's still alive.
Exort.
What the heck, man?
Oh my, bad news after bad news. For Team SDI, and this is the free lord, Geek Fam on the verge of victory, of getting 2-0s. And man,
Curtizzi,
such
play after play.
Blazing duets after blazing duets.
Yeah, wow. And
wow.
So far, so good here for Geek Fam. They need to finish this as soon as possible if they want to close this out. We haven't mentioned Crimson for a while now.
Yes.
I think he's just biding his time until he gets like a good item like a Wind of Nature or maybe Endless Battle maybe with the Lifesteal and the Spellbap item. So
I think this is the problem if your team doesn't have a good initiator.
Yeah.
Your carry will definitely go in front for him to get the damage going. But again, man, the zone.
Look at that. When he goes down low, he goes back right away.
Yeah.
And you're left with nothing to defend.
Yes. And again, the only person left for you to attack is the one in front of you, which is always, why not, the Kufra. And you will take time. It will definitely take time for you to get all the damage.
Great pickup.
All of these in these stacks. And man, that is a free tower there on the bottom side. Geek Fam hoping to end the dreams of SDI.
I'm about to end this massacre. That's what they're, the meme is real here happening right now. Why not inside the base though? He has immortality, so he's not super scared. And Exhort's so scary since earlier. May inside the base!
Whoa!
Goes for the finish!